Hello, everyone. Welcome to ViteConf 2023. I'm really excited to be here with you. And I don't know about you, but I'm getting really tired of seeing these virtual Zoom backgrounds from working remotely the past couple of years. And so I thought, you know, for today's keynote, wouldn't it be fun if instead of looking at this background, this virtual one, we actually went out and explored some of these backgrounds in real life. So without further ado, welcome to ViteConf, but also welcome to San Francisco. Throughout the keynote today, we're going to be exploring some of our favorite places in the San Francisco Bay Area, and what better place to start with than the Golden Gate Bridge. This is a great example of what great engineering looks like, something that's built to be durable, solid, nearly a century ago, and will be standing for decades and centuries to come, built for the purpose to enable millions of people to go places and do things that weren't possible before. And that's just like what Vite and StackBlitz are doing for the web ecosystem and for the web itself. Our vision at StackBlitz that we've been building towards for the past 6 years has been to actually build the first web native development environment. So actually built into your browser, you can use the web to build the web, because this would make development way faster and way simpler. You don't have to clone a repo to get started. You don't have to download anything. It just works instantly in your browser tab. But in order to have a great IDE experience, great development environment for the web, you need great tooling. You need a great SDK for the web. And that's where Vite has come in. And a couple of years ago, when we first discovered Vite, we had a lot of conviction that Vite was going to go to great places. And today, Vite is doing over 6.7 million downloads a week. Just extraordinary amount of growth. You don't see that type of growth. Since becoming the biggest financial backer of Vite in October of 2021, we've been doubling down on our investments in the Vite ecosystem. We brought on Matthias, one of the core maintainers of Vite. You may know him as Patak in the ecosystem. And most recently, we also brought in Johnson, who works on Volar, the language tooling for Vue and Astro for the Vite ecosystem as well, to work full-time at StackBlitz. And today, I'm excited to share that we are tripling down by adding on some more folks that we're supporting in the ecosystem. To start, Anthony Fu works over at Nuxt and is one of the most prolific folks in the JavaScript ecosystem at large, much less just the Vite ecosystem. And second, we're excited to be sponsoring Vladimir, who is the core maintainer of Vitest, the rapidly growing test framework built on Vite to work with the Vite ecosystem. And we're really excited to be supporting the project these folks are working on. So there's been a lot of awesome announcements already today at this year's ViteConf, and I've got some good news because we've got a couple more for you. So to start out, at last year's ViteConf, we announced a new product we had called CodeFlow. It allowed you to open instant development environments in your browser tab with your full VS Code running there, and you can open any tool chain. So you don't have to, when a coworker hits you up and says, hey, can you review my pull request? You don't have to stash your changes locally and then install everything. Ugh. You just open a link, do the pull request review, close it. Or you can just start a new project in one click. And I'm excited today to share that as of this quarter, we're going to be pulling CodeFlow out of beta. And I got to tell you, the experience of being able to start a new application or a new pull request or a new PR review in one click has been amazing to see in the community, especially in the Vite community. You know, our CodeFlow application has been adopted by the Vite core team and a whole bunch of the other projects in the ecosystem. And today we're excited to announce some new integrations that we've been working on for CodeFlow. And in particular, for design system teams. This has been one of the most common places that we see StackBlitz and CodeFlow being adopted to accelerate design system teams' ability to create their components, test them, review bug reports, have an instant one-click environment to try them out. And today, for the first time ever, not only can you have StackBlitz run your live examples for your design system components, but you can actually use StackBlitz to actually build the design system components themselves. So to talk more about this, I'm excited to hand things over to Tomek, one of our founding engineers, who's been working on our integrations with the ecosystem, is going to show you everything that we've been working on.
Hey, ViteConf. Today, I also decided to go outside and code a bit in my garden. It's really cool that we can work from many different places, like co-working spaces, cafes, or sometimes just another room for a change. In StackBlitz, we wanted to implement that principle in the digital world, to be able to jump into code from wherever you are. We move outside our core editors pretty often. For example, I do that when I'm looking at a component in Figma that Devon, our designer, has just updated, and I want to implement it. ideally, you know, without too much hassle, finding the project, the branch, and the right files. So last year at ViteConf, we've introduced a tool that allows you to put pr.new in front of a GitHub URL to get an instat dev environment. It's pretty awesome and already being used in many places, but this year we're building on top of that to bring you first-class integrations with the tools we all use. Let's see how we can bring design and code together with the core tools for design systems, Figma and Storybook. So for the ViteConf website, we've designed it in Figma. If you want to make a change to the headline of the site to reflect what's in the document, normally you'd have to go to the editor, open the ViteConf project, find the file, and so on. But here, I can instead just go ahead and click on this layer and see this handy StackBlitz link. It opens up in a new tab, all ready for me to make the change and submit the PR. And you can do this with any Figma layer. Attach the repository and any relevant file to it to have this one-click environment always available for a developer to jumpstart their work. Another example of this is Storybook. Oftentimes, you want to review the components in an isolated environment to make sure they're consistent. What if you realize you need to make a change to either the component implementation or the story definition file itself? Again, it's a pretty big lift. You have to clone the repository, open the environment, and so on and so on. So what if it's just one click? That's what our Storybook integration does. It opens up your project on that file with that component live in the preview. The only thing you or any other person on your team needs to do is make the changes, submit the PR. And like with Figma example, you can set it up for the whole project, the specific story, or even a variant of that story. So these were just small examples, but you can already see how we've removed friction to develop, maintain, and contribute to design systems. You start in Storybook or in Figma. You just click a dedicated link and you start coding. And you can do it from anywhere. The only thing needed is a browser. We're excited what it means for design systems, but we're not stopping there. We have plans for so many more integrations with the tools we use every day, like Jira, Raycast, or Linear. If you want to learn more, you can find all the relevant links at stackblitz.com/integrations. I hope you love these improvements to design system workflows as much as we do. And we're looking forward to hearing what you think. Now, back to you, Eric.
Thanks, Tomek. So we're pretty excited about the ecosystem integrations that we've been working on over here at StackBlitz, and we have a couple more that are going to be coming out soon. But we're also really excited about integrations that the ecosystem has been building with some of the stuff we've been making, in particular the WebContainer API, which allows you to boot an instant operating system with Node.js and NPM on any web page, which really expands the sort of things you can build inside of a web app. For example, the SvelteKit team made an awesome full-stack tutorial for their SvelteKit framework. Another great example of this is package size. You can type in the name of an NPM package, find out its size, a whole bunch of other things about it. You can convert images online using Sharp, etc. And we're really excited to see this grow. We now have over 500,000 developers a month using applications that have been created with the WebContainer API. But when we originally built WebContainers, we didn't just intend for them to be a way for you to build Node.js and JavaScript applications in the browser. We also envisioned them to be a way to build any type of application with any language or any runtime. And the key technology for enabling us to do this has been the future of WebAssembly. And about a year ago, we joined a group called the Bytecode Alliance, which is a consortium of companies that's got the sole mission of pushing WebAssembly forward and enabling it to do things and run in places that weren't possible before. And we've been working with this group around an exciting initiative called the WebAssembly System Interface, which gives you low-level system interfaces, which allows new types of languages and runtimes to work in WebAssembly. And today, we're really excited to announce that we're bringing the WebAssembly system interface to WebContainer. And this is a pretty big deal because this means you can now use the full desktop grade VS Code powered editing environment in StackBlitz to build Python applications or Ruby applications, C++ applications, and more. And I'm excited to hand it over to Dominic Elm, one of our founding engineers, the creator of WebContainer and the lead of our WebContainer engineering efforts over here at StackBlitz, who's going to show you a whole bunch more, talk about how we've been able to do this.
Thank you, Eric. You know, standing here, I'm reminded that in technology, just as in nature, we climb one peak only to see new summits on the horizon. With WebContainers, we've already scaled incredible heights, and we've redefined what browsers can do. It's the integration of cutting-edge and breakthrough technology, such as WebAssembly, that pushes boundaries and opens new possibilities. Today, I'm excited to announce the next peak on our journey. It's the integration of WASI, a technology that brings unprecedented new capabilities to WebContainers and the web development landscape. So what exactly is WASI? WASI stands for WebAssembly System Interface. It's like a bridge that allows WebAssembly modules to interact safely with the operating system, extending their capabilities and giving them file system access or allowing them to perform network operations and more, all while maintaining WebAssembly's sandboxed and secure environment. This allows developers to build applications in any language, C, C++, Rust, or Go, and compile to WebAssembly without having to tailor it specifically for the web or other environments. Now, why is this significant? WASI brings us three key benefits. First, it is fast and secure, embodying the essence of WebAssembly. Second, it's incredibly portable, meaning it will run the same way across different environments. Third, and most thrilling of all, it allows for a wide range of tool chains to run on StackBlitz.com, as well as provide multi-language support and much more. There are many tool chains and ecosystems that have recognized the power of WebAssembly and WASI. A prime example is WordPress. Not only has WordPress the majority of the market share among other CMS, with a whopping 64%, but it also powers an astonishing 43% of all websites on the internet. You can run the entire WordPress stack inside WebContainers. This unlocks full WordPress plugin development all within your browser. We're excited to work more with the WordPress team and other ecosystems as we continue to push the boundaries of what's possible. In addition, we're extremely thrilled to give you a sneak peek into the potential of WebContainers. As a demonstration of what's possible, we're launching experimental support for Python within WebContainers. This is especially significant when you consider that Python, the third most frequently used programming language, has traditionally been absent from the browser's native environment. As WASI continues to evolve and expand its feature set, it will directly influence the capabilities of Python within WebContainers. But what if I told you that this is just scratching the surface? WASI follows the motto of compile once, run everywhere. You can take your code written in a native language, such as Rust or C++, compile it to a WASI-compatible WebAssembly module, and it's ready to run in any environment that supports WASI, including WebContainers. Even more amazing, you can simply drag and drop your compiled WASI code directly into StackBlitz and run it from the terminal. It's that easy. This is not just multi-language support. This is a whole new paradigm for web development, and it allows to run a large spectrum of native applications on and off the web without dealing with multiple different architectures. It's a single compilation target for different platforms. You can try this today. Head over to StackBlitz.com, click on the newly introduced Native Languages tab, that's still in alpha, and start your Python project right away. In addition, we're shipping support for JQ, a well-known native command line JSON processor that you can use from the terminal in any project. So what's next? As these ecosystems and communities embrace WebAssembly and WASI, we plan to add support for more native languages such as Ruby, PHP, or even C++. And we're incredibly excited to collaborate with different communities and projects to push the web to new heights. Now back to Eric.
Thanks, Dom. We're really excited about bringing WASI into WebContainer and just unlocking a whole new world of applications that you can build inside of StackBlitz. And we're not stopping there. The advent of web GPU on the web has been prescient with the explosion of LLMs and AI. And we're excited to begin bringing web GPU and AI into StackBlitz as well in new ways that weren't possible before. So stay tuned. And our final announcement today is all this amazing stuff that you can do with StackBlitz now that supercharges your dev workflows. One of the most common requests we've heard from developers is, how can I use this at my company or with my team? Today, we have some brand new plans for you all that allow you to bring this to your startup, your open source project, or even the largest companies in the world. And there's two different plans we have available for this. One is our new team plan on StackBlitz.com. So if you have a GitHub organization, you can open up repos, instantly have one-click pull request reviews and create pull requests, have a shared workspace to share templates and different starting off points. If you're behind a firewall or working at one of the most security-conscious companies in the world, we have a new product called Enterprise Server, which allows you to install a version of StackBlitz behind your own firewall, in your own VPC, or even on-prem air-gapped. All the benefits of StackBlitz and can integrate with Bitbucket, GitLab, GitHub, and any Git provider for that matter. So we're really excited for the first time to bring StackBlitz to the largest companies and startups around the world. And you can get started today over at stackblitz.com/pricing. And we do have one more thing. We really appreciate the tens of millions of you that have tested out this technology and battle-hardened it over the past half decade as we've built this with our partner companies. And for those of you that want to bring this to your team, we've made a special t-shirt that you'll get when you sign up for StackBlitz Teams or Enterprise Server. And it's a pretty cool looking t-shirt. We made it just for you all. And all you have to do is if you go ahead and sign up over at StackBlitz.com, you'll get an email from us and give us your shipping information. We'll send it over to you. With that, I want to thank you for joining us on our journey here during the keynote today. And I hope you're as excited as our team is about the things we've shipped and announced. And we cannot wait to see the incredible web applications you're going to build with StackBlitz and Vite using these new tools and capabilities. So I hope you enjoy the rest of the talks here today at ViteConf, and we will see you on the trail ahead as we build a web ecosystem that is beyond fast. Thanks for coming.